Randalam. Okay, der Champagne-Schiller. Ah, damn. Okay, we here we are. It was a long ride. How deep exactly are we? I need to do what Rose asked first. I'll be right back. Be right back. Oh, kat sini je. Sorry for keeping you waiting. Let's go. Let's go then. First thing in the cellar, grab a car. Car? What do we need a car for? Don't know how big you think the cellar is. Take that number and multiply by 10. Cellar is a gigantic structure with multiple shuttle stops. We get around in these cars. Hop aboard. Ooh, automatic cars? Ooh, damn. God damn, Basancio, Nebukarim. This is a cellar. Wow, this is... You cannot quite tell from here. Those little dots up there are racked juicers. Hanging from the ceiling like sausages. Part of our job is to rack up juicers sent down by screening. What do you think? Not as expected? Thought the setup should be more futuristic-ish. No, I was kind of expecting this. I thought they should be in parts or something. I know what you mean. I thought the same before coming down here for the first time. Makes sense though, if you think about it. To have so many people racked up at the same time, they cannot afford to make the system too fancy. Here at Silencio, we use outdated hardware, but newer systems are much better. Cost control is key. The objective is to rack up as many people as possible. Economy of scale. Let's keep going. Let's go. Oh damn. Wasak gila wei. Nampak rain. Oh, I tadi terbang lah. Wow. Tak pasal dia nampak rain, guys. Future. This is it. Let's get off. I mean... Even Cyberpunk 2077 pun tak ada kereta terbang kan. This is descending row. Users line up here, wait to be racked up. This machine will keep them in place, inject necessary fluids and mount juicing hardware. Then they are moved into the cellar. This whole process is called racking. Doesn't look comfortable. Frankly, I don't know. Never tried it myself. But I guess it cannot be very enjoyable. These people are candidates sent down by screening. They look kind of doped. They are put into protective suits provided by the farm before wrecking. Beneath Silencio, we have a total of 10 cellars like this one. Hey Justin, is it break time? Yeah, I will start wrecking soon. Thank you for your hard work. Nah, your work is harder. My work is probably harder still. Shut up! It's about time, let's keep moving. Oh yeah, nak kena rank, ada Heng Liu lah. Kita punya jiran tu. Yeah. You! Heng Liu? It looks weird, those bloodshot eyes. You okay? I don't know, I feel... Calm down, it's going to be okay. You? I don't know you. I know him. I... Let me in. You say... Safe. I'm safe, no? I'm safe. I won't... Don't know what to say. This is absolutely safe. Relax. Good. I... Suddenly froze mid-sentence. The tranquilizer is kicking in. What? It's only natural to panic once they see what's going on here. To keep things smooth and safe, juicers are given tranquilizer and muscle relaxant before wrecking. That way they won't thrash around, which could harm themselves. That's why they are like zombies. Terrible, huh? See, you don't have any alternative. Yeah, this is the only way. Unlike screaming, we have to deal with this day in, day out. Let's keep moving. Ooh, enter. Hey you, where have you been? I was picking up new recruits, eh? Where's the statement? Working on it, we'll deliver before the end of the day. You'd better. You, the new guy? What a douche. Yes, just and I. Just answer me or yes or no. You didn't ask about the name because I don't care. Smarten up, stupid hunk. Sorry. And not a smart boy, but a good boy. Do your thing. Do your thing quick and get the fuck out of here.
What?
I sent you down for field practice. I let you do field practice, but keep in mind that we don't need you. Finish your business, then fuck off. Understand? And you, Wu, don't use him as an excuse to delay the statement. I'm right here in my office watching you. Yes, sir. So clown, what's the clown's problem? Sorry about that. Don't be, not your fault. Yeah, you're right. Let me show you around the office. Hold on, you said you don't need me. What does that mean? Honestly, I don't think we need any new recruits either. Honestly, I'm not surprised. You are not hiring? Well, you could say that, but Silencio wants to assign you to ops for whatever reason. We are in no position to say no. My work is done, Justin. Did you follow procedure E5? I don't want to see any more compliance issues. Yes, sir. Strictly followed E5. Penelope. Good. Take a break. Thanks, Justin. Hey, Justin. Hey, how are things going? Not bad. I finally bypassed the loop. Thanks for your help. It's a makeshift fix. Don't forget to locate the root cause. Roger, will do. This is very unlike screening. They are meticulous like clockwork. I don't think their asshole lead could manage it though. Justin must be the one doing all the management work. Come over here, Justin. Justin, do you have a minute? Sorry, I'm occupied. I will take a shot, Jesse. Sorry. I see. Leave it to me. Go do your work. Yes, sir. Is Justin sighing? Jesse, well, hi. Welcome back. What's with that fixed smile? Vic, what are you talking about? You know what? Plus, Kaylee is was complaining again about you. Aha! Where is Kathy? She's not with you? We all know Kathy, huh? Kathy, she's back to screening. Hold on, don't try to distract me. I told you over and over again, don't redo other people's work. You are making teamwork impossible. I told you over and over again, I don't need teamwork. You see, Missy Kaylee has been stuck on the same error for a full week. You know that? I rewrote her code and had it resolved in 3 minutes. What's she bitching about? You undid her work? How is she supposed to cooperate with you? Your deliverables are due in a month. Sorry. You think I cannot make it all by myself? Believes you can, but you are missing an opportunity to learn about teamwork. Money, Paxton. Sooner or later, you will have to work with someone. What do you do then? There, I said it for you, Justin. Thanks, Pax. At least find someone competent. Like Pax, it's not bad. No way, do you think I don't know you told him to leave everything to you? That is not teamwork. Okay, I'll restore her code. If the deliverables are delayed, it's all your fault. No, it's your fault. Hey Justin, is this the newbie? Pretty face. Sorry, I forgot to introduce. Hello, Jesse Lai. I'm Pax. New people in the eye when you speak. Hi all, I'm Jason Dai. Hi. Does he have engineering background? Justin looked at me expectantly. but I don't have any engineering background to speak of. I don't. Damn it, another what? Is the AI really working? Why does it keeping sending people without engineering training down here? Now I agree with Eva, yeah, Silencio is going nuts. You know better than anyone that Silencio doesn't make mistakes. No, I know better than anyone that no one knows a thing about how Silencio works. She's got a point. None of you knows how it works and you follow its instructions without a question. It's sending a clueless guy who's never written a single line of code to an engineering division. What are we supposed to do? Train him? Actually, I had programming classes in high school and I did pretty well in exams. Little coding and AU exams. Incredible fucking bull. Think, Justin, think. Do you have the time and energy for this right now? We never planned to keep him. Am I right, Justin? Oh, what? You are right. What? Is the decision up to you? Listen to me, Jason. Jesse may be aggressive, but she is making a good point. I did a research and confirmed that you don't have any real experience in programming. I cannot admit you into ops. The situation here is dire. We do not have the time to or resources to train you. Dire? What's that supposed to mean? It's complicated, but we saw what our division lead is like. Not the most dependable leader. I particularly run this place and that alone is burning me out. In that case, my chance of securing a job here is down by 50%. So what happened next? We are not like screening. We need real professionals, not smooth talkers with outstanding people skills. Suggesting that the screening team are not professional. I see why they don't like ops now. Playing by the book, I should walk you through everything we do at ops, but today I will challenge you with the hardest part of it. When we see how you are not fit for ops, then I will let Monsieur know. You don't have the guts to reject me, alright? How do you know she's gonna listen? She always listens to division leads. Think about your field practice at screening. Monsieur considers Wing's opinion of when she gives the final verdict. When you're not the lead of ops, trust me, Mr. knows how who's actually doing the work. Plus, the actual division leads wants you even less. In short, he cannot do the job. Jesse, what? What? I'm saying it out loud for you. Being honest with him or not, it doesn't change anything. If he cannot do it, he cannot do it. I feel like I must say something. Isn't there any position that doesn't need engineering or programming background? As you can see, everyone here is either an engineer or a programmer, most with 4 or more years of experience. You know what? The division lead, no need for any background. As long as you know the right people at HQ. What about wreckers? I mean, all they do is send juices up. It's an idea. It's about wrecking time. If he's here for field practice, let him have a try. Wait, we don't have any opening for new wreckers. But we do need more, no? There's no opening only because the lead doesn't authorize hiring. It's making everyone's life miserable. Wouldn't comment on that, but the bottom line is I can authorize an opening. Hey, isn't Grandpa Lee about to retire? Yeah, he did mention that. I thought the company's policy does allow to us to recruit reserves when there is staff retirement imminent. Correct? While you read the company's policy? I did my homework before applying for the job. Never walk into a place without knowing it front and back, my motto. Good for you. Okay, let's do this then. Great. You, Justin. Don't celebrate yet. You are not officially hired. I think I deserve thank you too. Thank you too. Listen, Jason. Wrecker is not an easy job. I mean, labor intensive. Physical labor won't be your primary concern. Your mental stress is enormous. Also, even if you are recruited as a reserve, you cannot start as a wrecker right away. As an apprentice period, mentored by senior wreckers. Thank you for everything. My pleasure. Since you may actually join ops, there is one thing you should know. Sudden change of attitude. At ops, we generally agree that silencio should be shut down. The sooner the better.
What?
You're applying for a job that may not last very long. We want the farm to be shut down. In the division that manages the cellar, we know how bad things are. With equipment out of date and underserviced, we will see more and worse accidents in a couple of years. We want the farm to be shut down to avoid such casualties. Is it an official decision yet? No, but the board of directors is considering it. Truth be told, we have no deciding power in the closure of the farm. However, we do what we can to facilitate it. I know you have a hard time dealing with the idea, but this is the reality. Why are you telling me this now? Because I don't want you to make uninformed decisions. I have done my duty to inform. Let's see which wrecker is free to oversee your field practice. Feel free to walk around or maybe talk to Jesse or Pax. Come find me when you are ready to start. So, kita cakap dengan JC dulu, I think. Yo, looking for me, handsome? What do you do here? Oh, wanna more, know more about me? The thing is, you wouldn't understand if I told you. Come on, try me. Aha, sure. Since you are so curious, my title is Senior Technician. What I do is the logical deconstruction of neural networks. Ah, I see the question marks on your head. Simply put, my responsibility is to figure out how AI algorithms work. Your team created a Silencio's algorithm, no? Yes, we made it so that it can learn new things and expand itself, given a ton of data and training. Eventually, it becomes something totally beyond our comprehension. You could say that it knows far more about us than we know about it. Am I clear enough? I mean, it's capable of thinking? Sounds like Skynet thinking. Depends, what's your definition of thinking? Like press a button and get a response, is your computer thinking? Or instruct the computer to do this thing and that? Is it thinking about how to get things done? Or let's talk about this, my stupid ass neighbor who never remembers to pick up after his dog. He has a human brain, but is he capable of thinking? Come on, what do you think a thinking is? I think it's making judgment and decision based on provided information. Thinking means feelings and emotion. Thinking is making judgments. Input, processing and output, huh? In that case, yeah, our algorithm is capable of thinking. My neighbor isn't. Tons of input, no processing. Vision is the leader in this field. If I could gain access to their data and resources, my research work could be massively easier. You know what? Jesse used to be a senior scientist at Sunrise. The resume gave me more trouble than benefit. Trouble? Vision has trust issues. Especially to former Sunrise employees. For a long time, I was treated like a spy. Come on. Come on, what kind of idiot spy does infiltration by sending over a job application? Justin tried everything to talk the management into keeping Jesse here. That guy has eyes for talent. Not a great job, but hey, this isn't half bad either. All I care is about my research. Now that I have free access to key data, no complaint. Anything else you wanna know? Okay. Kita dah bersama dengan Pax pula. Hi, can I help you? What do you do here? Good question. My job is the most critical in this office. Bullshit. I'm the one, the only hardware technician at Ops, at least for now. Basically, I operate and repair everything except for some parts of the wrecking system. Without me, these weak ass quarters cannot get a thing done. I don't know that don't know nothing about these wonderful machines they use. Sounds a lot like QQ's responsibilities. I know a heart retention and screening. I know him. He turns sulky at the mention of QQ. Pax doesn't like that guy. Thinks the guy stole his mojo. Well, they are both chubby nerds and working on boring hardware. Ours is extra nerdy and petty, maybe. Yeah, who the heck needs two chubby nerds in the same company? Obviously, I'm the superior one, so I kindly tolerate him. Have you met? We met a couple of times, including the company's tech showcase conference the other day. Oh, do me a favor, if you run into him next time, tell him that our showdown is nigh. What showdown? Har har, don't mind him, he's in drama mode again. He wants to outshine screening's chubby nerd with something awesome in the next tech showcase conference. You know what, I think the other guy isn't even aware of his existence. Only a coward backs out of a duel. That's about it. Anything else you would want to know? You know Justin pretty well? What made you think that? Just me smoke for me. So you finish his sentence more than once. Yeah, that. Don't encourage him. He tries to predict people's next sentences all the time. Smartass. You're most senior staff at Ops, practically brothers. Most senior because he never had a chance of promotion. Brothers work together. I won't take a promotion until he is promoted. How is his promotion going? Simple, I can answer that. Justin is about the only one in the whole company who would consider promoting him. He is Pax's only hope. Totally untrue. Justin has been waiting forever to be the division lead. I don't have the heart to leave my brother behind. In a session, I'm stuck here forever. No! There's no way the asshole could cling to his position that long. Which asshole? Our team lead Sir Kevin Hu, the glorious. Guy came out of nowhere just when Justin was about to be promoted and has been the team lead ever since. Now the right people at HQ in you'll go a long way, living and simple. Basically goes does nothing other than sweep bad stuff under the carpet. To give a few examples, anything that proves he's an incompetent leader. Plus those Jesse, Mr. Dai doesn't need to know that. Gotcha. Know what? What I better not say. Saying too much could get us in trouble. Sorry. Is she apologizing for? Mr. once wanted to fire him, tried and failed multiple times. Poor Justin. Yeah, I feel sorry for him. Wanted to give him a hand, but who are we, huh? One is spy suspect from Sunrise, the other a salary thief. What can we do? Nothing. Should I tell a friend about this? Anything else you want to know? Nope. Okay. They would have talked again, actually. I'm gonna help you. Nope. Someone you're cutting and... looking for me and some... nothing. Okay. Kita kita pusing dulu. And you call yourself a wrecker? But I... know half about your job. I'm not experienced like you, okay? You live and learn. Who's this? Oh, that is Kaylee. Oh, hi, the new guy? I don't know yet. Haha. What's up? We have never met before, right? Yeah, never. Uh-huh. Why are you talking to me then? Kind of expecting me to say something? You're not the kind of who tries to start a conversation with everyone at every new job, are you? And counting on us to tell you everything there is to know about this job? Sorry if I'm bothering you. Aha, weirdo. Let me think. I'll start with a self-introduction. I'm Kaylee Chan. I have an answer for everything. Oh, Kaylee. Hey, you love birds? Ha, we are just... wow, this must be a new guy. We don't know yet. Come on, Kaylee, don't be so mean. Well, he said to show himself. Hello, I'm Yat Ki. Penelope Lai. Listen, Dai, nice to meet you. Nice to meet you too. Me too. See you around, Kaylee. We have places to be. You think while on duty, huh? Yep. Of course not. Those two are kind of... sweet. Ah, that's a nice way of putting it. Say, aren't we chatting for too long? Is that a bad thing? Not a bad thing per se. It's just that I have work to do. Can catch up later if you manage to get a job, that is. Haha. Hey. That's it for now. See you later. Alligator. Kaylee, please. No. Heston told you to work with me. This way is much faster. I told you no. It's faster to let you do it all right, but we cannot maintain your code. I'll make the architecture super clear with tons of annotations. It's not as simple as that. Don't you trust me? Never gave me a reason to trust you. What's your problem, Jesse? Can't you just work as part of a team? It's slow. No one is asking you to be quick, but don't you want more time for your pet projects? You get more time if the team project stretches longer, no? I don't get what your problem is. And I'll leave the whole thing to you. What? Never mind. See, now, meeting the deadline is never part of your concern. You just don't want to work with others. Say, you have never participated in any teamwork since joining us. Am I right? Right. I avoid teamwork as much as I could. Why? Because I'm not a team person. Huh? Forget about it. I'll try my best to work with you. Happy now? Okay, as part of the team, it's your responsibility. Hey, I know, right? Sorry for being a troublemaker. You're not so bad yet. Haha. Enjoying the show, huh? What show? Hey, you. Never mind. Forget about it. We're done talking, right? I'll go back to work then. Uh-huh. Weirdo, isn't she? You mean Jesse? Of course. Kinda like hanging out with weirdos of her kind, though. Extremely smart people are often quirky. Okay, enough chit-chat. Do whatever they ask you to do. Okay, tak apa dah. So, sebelum kita check up dengan dia, maybe kita boleh keluar. Maybe, what is this? The ops team uses this on daily basis to rack and unrack contributors. So, the radiation level is in the cellar is going up. You get the iodine pills. I did, although, do those pills really make any difference? They should do, as long as you don't stay in the cellar for too long. Damn, I'm gonna have a full day shift day after tomorrow. Inner facade maintenance. But you won't be exposed. There's the protective suit. Am I supposed to feel better? Shoot, I've never heard of anyone on our team getting sick because of the radiation. Juices are a different story though. Being racked up, totally exposed for months or even days. It does a number of them. The racking system is exposed because in a normal working cellar, there shouldn't be any radiation. I know, right? Never mind. Nobody. Backup power supply. Power supply to for the wrecking system. So necessary. So drop the wrecking may cause permanent injury or death. Lime. So, what you want? Hostility at first sight. Mr. Sue. I have nothing to say to imbeciles from screening. I'm not from screening. Then why are you in their uniform? Huh, hold on. Must be Jason Dye? Right. My boss said you'd come today. Astin is not your boss. If he does the boss's job, he is the boss. Nonsense. Oh, you did field practice of screening yesterday? Yes, so he could end up in either screening or ops. Right. Nope. Word of advice, stay clear of screening. What's his issue against screening? Don't be like that, Mr. Su. Ethic is from screening and you get along with her just fine. Kathy is different. She's a good girl. How did they know Kathy? You know Kathy, sir? Of course, she comes here quite often these days. And bombarding Mr. Su with questions, she's very curious about how this machine works. If only you are half as motivated as she is, slacker. Ha ha ha. Wait, you know Kathy too? The man just glanced at me. Sure, I see. She's the only one in the entire screening who cares about what's happening down here. The rest of them only bitch about how we are uncooperative, never for once suspecting they are the root of the problem. What do you mean? Another clueless newbie. What did I say, eh? They don't care. He's a newbie, Mr. Su. Of course he's clueless. If you don't explain, he will stay clueless. The cellar is slowly falling apart. We are in no shit to take in more juicers. But the screening people don't listen. They are even lowering the bar to let more people in. Bunch of bastards willing to kill people for their performance review. I know, right? The point is, we must reason with them first. Why would I waste my breath on them? Give it a try, will ya? Kathy said the other day that some people at screening want to know more about us. Like there's this new guy defending her in an argument. New guy even said they should get to know how the cellar works. Hold on, new guy? Wouldn't happen to be you, Mr. Dai? Yeah, I did defend Kathy when she had an argument with QQ. Sounds like me. Ah, small world. It's you, huh? Okay, maybe I did jump to conclusions. Maybe you are not one of them idiots. Suddenly he is much more approachable. You're a lot nicer than when Kathy is involved. I see you are treating her like a granddaughter. Shut up. Come on, your apprentice could use some grandfatherly love too. then be a good apprentice like Kathy first. Shut up for a start. I'm trying to keep the elderly company. Bullshit. Despite saying that, he cannot hide a smile. So what you want? I want to learn more about your work. Wipe the stinky ass for screening is what we do. Our routine work includes racking out for juices and keeping the wholesaler maintained and serviced. I thought logistics should be responsible for that. Maintaining servicing is the part of logistics. A lot of people think that. It's really annoying. Haha. The equipment in the cellar is based on entirely different technologies. The logistics team is not trained for this. Every hardware engineer you see here belongs to ops. Although some of them don't want to think so. It's a little shit's thing. They are too good to be one of us. These days we are increasingly involved in cleaning up. Enough, Yel. He doesn't need to know how to know so much. Yes, you're right. Need to know what? Anyhow, that's about the size of it. Anything else you want to know, Mr. Dai? Nothing. Okay. Aku macam. Aku macam nak kerja kat under sini. I don't know. As an engineer, you know? I don't know. You ready? Shall we start wrecking now? Let's start. Sure. You ready for the wrecking procedures? Let's start now, Pax. Roger. This is the new guy? Yes. I'll do the introduction. This is Mr. Liam Su, senior operator. No need, we have done the self-introduction already. I see. Enough chit-chat, let's get this done. You ready for it, boy? I'm ready. Good, this is very straightforward. Very straightforward? Why was Justin so nervous then? Wait, Mr. Su. Why? What? This is a great opportunity to make Mr. Da understand. Understand what? Where this farm must go? Yes. I said no need. I see no need. He can see for himself. Let's get going. The wrecking consoles is over there. Pull up, Yil. Coming. Yale. Yil. Good. Hey, Justin, I gave it another thought, and do you really think this is a good idea? Nothing will go wrong. Mrs. Su has him covered. Listen, Jason. Mrs. Su may sound grumpy, but he's a very practical man. He appreciates talent, although sometimes the attitude may suggest otherwise. Whether you like it or not, this is your only opportunity if ops is what you want. Just take it seriously. Come on, we are about to begin. Okay, let's go. I said banyak action more than, you know, talking. Golgotha Mark 3. Mission's original automated wrecking system. This thing belongs in a museum. This is where they wreck people up. Sorry, aku punya camera block the dialogue. Some of the dialogue. Sorry, guys. What are you doing there? Come closer and watch. You know what we are doing here? Yes. Tell me then, what do you do? I send those in line out there to juicing. About half right. We saw those juicers hanging up in the cellar. Before we rack them up, they must be prepared. Turn on the conveyor belt, yeah. Set mounting mode to manual. Aye, Captain. We need entry E758 Howard Ho. Ni dia tunjuk kot macam mana dia buat, apa yang dia buat. Wow. Yale will demonstrate how wrecking is done. Basically, you do everything with this console. The process is simple enough, but we cannot afford to get anything wrong. Now you watch. First, knock the juicers out in case he struggled and hurt himself. Are they already drugged? Huh? You did your homework. The tranquilizer is my stuff. We need them to walk up, not pass out in the corridor. This is the real deal, or the mounting process will hurt a lot. Yale, inject trank. Tranquilizers, eh? Ooh, man. Most juicers will be hanging up there for years. To keep them alive, we give them sustenance, a mixture of nutrients and sedatives. And which line are we using today? Line 2, silly ass. Alright, line 2. Next, connect them to silencer. Electric shock now. Yes, sir. Damn, this cheap sustenance. You pay shit and you get shit. He's still convulsing. Is he okay? Of course he's okay. Spasm is normal. That user just now was jerking while awake. It was a problem. Convulsing like this is normal? And that zap hurts like hell. Say, when are we gonna have money for real sustenance, Justin's? Next week? It's a full month away. Fuck me. Let's continue. Notice the juices is jerking? Can I not notice? Yes. Good. The juices brain generates flops, weakly stimulating his brain to keep it working. The stimulation process also generates noise signals that makes his limbs jerk. Next, we cut off his peripheral nervous system that will stop the jerking. Yale, attach insulation. Ooh. In this step, we take over his central nervous system, connecting his brain to the flop network. Each juicer is assigned to a domain. You can find the domain code in the screen over there. Where are the screens? Over there? Just manually confirm the domain code, no mistake allowed. Back him up, Yale. After the preparation, the system will transfer the juicer into the cellar. Nico, tadi tu. Okay, that's it. Like I said, plain and simple. Just follow the routine. Simple indeed, but why isn't it automated? Any question? Why don't you just automate the whole routine? Because of the risk. Mr. Su did say Golgotha is an automated ranking system, remember? The reason why we do everything manually is because this piece of shit is falling apart. This thing hasn't been working properly for 2 years. It's breaking down. The automation system is falling apart. Now we have to put someone in this control room to keep things going. Ha, control room? It's used to be maintenance nook for a couple of engineers to do troubleshooting and servicing. This means the crowded space. We crammed a manual mounting console here and made it a control room. On good days, the system works on its own. But somebody must stay here and keep watch and take over with manual control if or when it refuses to work. And most importantly, fix issues as they pop up. This is why we need Mr. Su here all the time. Anything else, boy? In the ministry again? Thought you asked. Yale, tell him how this goes again. Me? Any other Yale here? Yes, sir. First goes the real deal Trank. And sustenance. Real deal Trank. Sustenance. Today's sustenance, we are using line 2, right? You better not get this wrong again. Ahem, sometimes the juicers will feel the pain when attaching sustenance line. If that happened, we knock them out with electric shock. Mind you, don't juice shock unless they respond negatively to sustenance. It hurts a ton. Next, pull this lever in exactly this order. Pull these levers in exactly this order. Side. Tranquilizer. Lepas tu, sustenance and the apa? Line apa yang mereka patut naik. Lepas tu, shock jika bila mereka dah tranquilizer tu. Yeah, exactly in this order. Last, attach insulation and confirm domain. Last, attach insulation. Insulation kat kepala tu, confirm domain. Each user has an assigned domain. Find the domain number on that screen there. Ni, sini kot. User has an assigned domain. Find the domain number on that screen there. Then it's done. Remember it well. Your turn next. I have any more question? One last thing. See that yellow lever over there? Ni? That's the emergency stop. Pull it if the machine goes nuts. That will stop the whole system in case the juicer gets hurt or killed, if you are to so understand. Has that happened a lot? Never happened until 2 years ago. A couple of times we by the end of last year. Since this year, at least once a month. Once a month? You're thinking, ha, is enough. Things go wrong, pull lever. No, it sounds really challenging. Don't worry, if timing is your concern, you have plenty of time to pull the lever. In fact, it's not what you need the most. It's courage. Courage? The moment you pull the lever, a lot of parts will get damaged. According to the company's bullshit regulations, if they decide the action is not justified, meaning the juicer will die if you didn't pull the lever. All this damage will be your liability. You break it, you pay for it. Killed? Isn't the risk of injury alone enough to justify it? Should put the lever unless I'm gonna die? Right. I know this sounds ridiculous. It's a calculated decision based on risk and indemnities. Insurance claim wouldn't surpass the cost of an emergency stop unless the juicer is in question is killed during wrecking. Otherwise, if the juicer is not in immediate danger of death, being a crippled juicer is better than fixing a broken machine, or so the big bosses think. A lot of wreckers don't have the guts to pull the lever. How could they? What's more important than life? Listen up, boy. Those hypocrites at screening have no idea what it's like down here. Here, left alone doesn't solve your problem. When Vision goes after you or for compensation, it doesn't target you alone. Everyone close to you will be on their list. Family, friends, natural persons, legal entities, everyone with something to do with you is a target. You thought Sunrise has a killer legal team? Well, Visions is even better. Sunrise? They have enough dirty tricks to get things done outside the courtroom. Justin gave me an inquisitive glance. What? Can I say bad things about my old employer? Guess you've heard enough. Now you see what the problem is? Suppose you pull the lever and they decide the UC is not in immediate danger. And you are screwed, so it's everyone close to you. Wishing could potentially target Fran for what I do. You still think you have the guts? It's like, will definitely happen. I put it like that because it will definitely happen. Muppet's Law, ever heard of it? Murphy's Law. Whatever. Guys, enough talk. Let Justin start. Let's see how he handles this job. I'm not expecting much, mind you. Remember, a large part of this job is about keeping you cool. Aku sesepat akan naikkan Hank Liu untuk aku punya turn lagi. If you get the fundamental routine wrong, I won't keep you at odds. It's much harsher than Wayne. Besides, there's no trap or test this time around, if I feel I'm out of the game. Make some room for him, yeah. Your turn, Jason.